Bring it on one night, Willie.
Ryan Reynolds, I think, has like an editor in his brain that stops him from saying something really horrible, whereas Wade Wilson does not. He just says it all. So he's kind of unfiltered and crass and vile. And, you know, I think that's where I relate to him in as much as I can't help it. Since I was a kid, I think whenever I'm in like an uncomfortable position or something, I think, what's the worst thing I could say right now? And I don't say it, but what's the worst thing I could say right now? Whereas with Wade Wilson, I can just act on that impulse, sort of with impunity. Like I can kind of, you know, because if it works for the movie, great. If it doesn't, we just don't put it in the movie. But it's sort of freeing in that regard. Also, and at the end of the day, Deadpool wants to be a better person. You know, he really genuinely wants to be a better person. He isn't the best person, and he knows it, you know, and I think we all relate to that to some degree. Well, the X-Force is, you know, is something that it was a natural transition for Deadpool. We want him to go on, the next film will be the X-Force film, and that stuff's important because the X-Force is, they're morally flexible. They're guys that sort of don't, they'll do the things that the X-Men can't do or won't do. And that's a good fit for Deadpool. Deadpool doesn't really play by the rules. He doesn't believe in rules. He believes in doing what's right, you know. He governs his life by his own set of personal ethics, not someone else's. Whereas the X-Men is like a military sort of thing. There's an order, there's a reason for everything. So that was sort of the logical next step, you know, was introducing X-Force, introducing Cable in the movie, introducing Domino, introducing other X-Force characters, and then you know, having those guys take off and become their own unit. Oh, I don't think Deadpool's their leader. I think Deadpool thinks he's their leader. I think they all realize, like, this man is not in charge of anything. This man shouldn't be in charge of putting his own pants on. So I love that. I love that, like, as he's barking out orders to the X-Force guys, they're all just sort of, like, staring at him like, is this for real? You know, and you know, as we find out in the movie, Deadpool is not someone to be followed. Deadpool should only be a soldier. He should not be a leader. I don't consider Deadpool a hero, no. I consider Deadpool something in between. I don't even consider him an anti-hero, because he doesn't willfully do the wrong thing. He just can't help it. I consider Deadpool kind of like a teenager. He's sort of like a petulant teenager who's impulsive and short-sighted and myopic and sees just only what's in front of him, you know? And it's one of my favorite lines in the movie, which is that, you know, Cable says to Deadpool, well, Deadpool says to Cable, you know, I bet 50 years from now we're best buddies. And Cable says 50 years from now you're all dead. You know, you guys screwed the world into a coma and the world is gone. And Deadpool just kind of laughs and says, ah, planets. And I think it says everything to me about the character, because he doesn't care about planets or saving the world. That's never his thing. That's the Avengers, or that's the Justice League, or that's all those other. He just cares about saving this kid. So he's good, but he's not this grand sense of virtue, you know, which I love. Well, I think one thing I've learned is that, like, people are very complicated. You know, they're a mixed bag, and there's this idea of nature versus nurture is something that's important to me, and it's a theme in the movie as well. You know, that I think, you know, Wade Wilson came out of the shoot this certain way in life, and life is changing him, and that's okay. And a lot of people say that that's not possible, but it is possible. So the nurture is changing him, and that's sort of what we project onto the kid in this movie, which is that, you know, is it nature versus nurture? This kid, can one act of kindness actually change the whole world? And that's what Wade is fighting for in this moment, is to show this kid one act of kindness and selflessness and how that might affect the whole future.
Lo siento, amor, lo siento.